We're at the third annual Skill Wings Academy, one of Marcus's teammates here, Mr. Marsh. Kind of let the people know how you and Marcus became cool playing together at Tulane.
Just a natural bond. I mean, y'all know Marcus. He's just that kind of guy. He's a genuine dude. So from day one, we hit it off, and I mean, it's just been family ever since.
Do you still reside in the New Orleans area?
I'm in Baton Rouge.
Baton Rouge.
Stay down there. I got me a house out there about 6 years ago when I finished playing ball in 2010.
Sure. Now, I was told that the hardest person you had to play against was Dwayne Wade. Is anybody else you would say who's number two?
Wagner was, you know, he was up there. I played against Kenyon Martin, Cincinnati. Conference USA was strong back then. I mean, every night we had somebody different. So, I mean, those three probably come to mind first.
What do you think about the talent in the camp this year?
A young girl camp was serious.
Really?
I was telling Marcus, man. I could have put five girls out of there that could have went and took and beat a high school team in Baton Rouge.
Sure.
I mean, they had some really good young talent out there. Man. It was good to see.
Yeah. At 16 years old, what would you tell yourself now that you didn't know when you were 16?
Focus, man. That was the most important thing. Discipline gets you riches, is what I like to tell all my players. You know, if you discipline and you stay focused at a young age, I mean, nothing but good can come from that.
As far as hooping now, is the situation, you still hoop?
No, I got my own AAU organization. Okay. I got 9 teams. I mean, I'm done. I hung my shoes up a few years ago. It's all about the kids. Yeah, definitely. Just giving back now, man.
How's the AAU going for you?
It's good, man. Usually we take a group of kids, my older group, we go to Vegas every year. You know, I got my best player, he just committed and he started his first year at Virginia Tech. Trying to get kids to the next level, man, do what basketball did for me.
Yeah, so speaking of the next level, what was your fondest memory of playing overseas, playing professionally?
MVP, by far. Playing MVP of the league, winning the championship. Obviously the money, getting paid for doing something you love.
Yeah, but,
just winning, man, just being on top.
As somebody that's been overseas, what would you tell somebody right now that's going overseas, the most important thing?
Focus, man. Lock in. You know what I'm saying? It's real easy once you get overseas and, you got the freedom, you're making money, you got, all kind of distractions to just lose focus of what you're there for. But if you lock in and you take care of business, then, you can make a career, but a long career.
Yeah. So what do you think about, as far as basketball in 2018? What's your opinion on it? How is it going? Is it going the right way? Do you like the way basketball is being played right now?
I mean, it's evolving. I don't want to say I'm one of them kind of old school kind of guys, but I understand things evolve and change. I'm not really a fan of the 6'11 point guards always. I think sometimes, you can go down and get under the basket and mix it up sometimes. But, I mean, it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? Everybody's evolving.
Everything changed.
Yeah.
We appreciate you sitting in with us, man, for sure. If you got anything you want to tell the listeners.
Man, I appreciate you guys for having me, man. Y'all doing a great thing and just keep it going.
There it is.